the time in your life when everything had felt so wrong, so terrible, that you think it's almost like a dream. Like you're waiting for someone to reach out and pinch you so you'd wake up. 3 years ago, it was the summer before my junior year. I knew someone who felt like that. Like he was in a dream. That person just happened to be my best friend. The person you can go to for all the answers. That day, he was the one asking the questions. But you know, I couldn't give him the answers. Somehow I wish I did. Let me tell you what I mean. Like I said, it was 3 years ago. I had just gotten home from school. I got a phone call from my best friend Mike's father. He said there was something wrong with him. He hadn't been in school that day. He was home, enraged about something. That's why I went over there, to find out just what was wrong.
Blake? I told my father I didn't want anybody here. Now get the hell out.
Get that damn thing out of my face.
I mean it, Greg. Leave me alone. Don't make me do something I don't want to do.
Blake, man, what's gotten into you? Where'd you get that? Why don't you lighten up?
Why don't you get the hell out of here?
Come on, Mike. I'm your friend. I wish you'd tell me what's wrong.
I just need to be alone right now. That's it.
I'm not leaving you until you tell me what's wrong.
Greg, can't you see that the only thing I want right now is to be alone?
Mike, don't you realize that this is not a game? That those are real bullets and this is real life? Now why don't you just give me the gun before someone gets hurt?
You don't get it, do you? This is my house and I want you out now.
What I do get is you possibly want to hurt someone with that gun. Maybe even yourself.
You don't know how I feel.
What I do know is that you were planning on killing yourself, weren't you? Answer me.
I don't have to tell you anything.
Come on, Mike. I'm your friend. You can talk to me. Mike, talk to me, please.
You just wouldn't understand. You see, you got it all. Good grades, lots of friends, nice-looking girlfriend. Look at me. I've got nothing. You hear me? Nothing. Sometimes I wonder why we're even friends.
Is that what's bothering you? Mike, we've been friends since we were 5 years old. You've got great qualities about yourself. You're fun to be with. You got a great sense of humor.
Greg, there are lots of people in this world who don't look for those qualities in a person.
How would you know if someone doesn't like you or not?
It's kind of obvious.
Mike, do you remember that time at camp when I had a crush on that girl? I was for sure she liked me. But she liked you the whole time. Do you remember that? See what I mean? There's lots of people that like you. They like you for what you are. Not whether you have good grades or a nice-looking girlfriend. Just you.
Yeah, right.
Mike, there's something you're not telling me. And it can't be just someone not liking you.
Do you really want to know? Is that what you want? All right, I'll tell you. Remember that party I went to about 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, that one at Nancy Miller's house. The one I thought you should have gone to because of all the friends she hangs out with. And it might what happened.
Will you just shut the hell up? Listen, That night at the party, that girl, Tina, she was coming on to be pretty strong. We went upstairs. I thought you wanted to, you know, fool around. When we got upstairs, these kids up there, they were getting high, man. I didn't know what to do. For so long. Anything is gonna happen. Greg, I didn't take the drugs that you're leading up to.
Then what happened?
Well, they offered it to me. I said no. They laughed, Greg. Never felt so bad in my life. I was walking home from school a couple of days ago. And there they all were, just sitting there, smoking. I was gonna turn around and walk the other way, but something told me I should just keep on going. So I did. And when I was walking past them, that kid, Mark, he said to me, "Hey, Mike, you wanna drag up my cigarette or your mommy won't let you?" And they all started laughing. So I told him to shut the hell up and get out of my face.
That's good. That's what you should have done.
No, it wasn't. Because of that, he beat me to a pulp right there in front of everybody. There was nothing I could have done. Damn, why couldn't I have done anything?
So, this is why you want to kill yourself?
No, you don't understand.
Yes, I do.
Oh, no, you don't. Every day I'm gonna have to face those kids. Every damn day. Greg, I did the wrong thing. I should have just taken the damn crack.
Mike, you saying no that day was probably the hardest, most wisest decision you'll ever make in your entire life. But not your friends. You don't have to impress them.
They hate me.
No, they don't. They're probably just as confused as you are.
They still hate me.
No, they don't. Why don't you give me the gun?
I said they hate me.
No, they don't. Now give me the gun.
No.
Give it to me.
Leave me alone.
Give me the gun, Mike.
I said leave me alone.
Yeah.